This is Tom Radke, and do you have diabetic neuropathy, diabetic nerve pain, numbness, burning, tingling? I'm gonna go over what the studies show, how to get this as good as possible, how to avoid infection, foot problems, deformities, how to get stronger, how to start feeling better. We're gonna show you what all the research shows, what the remedies are, and we're starting right now. Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. We appreciate your likes, your subscribes, your comment. We really love hearing if this stuff helps. It really makes a big difference for us, so thank you. So diabetes is one of the, if not the single biggest cause of numbness, peripheral neuropathy in the feet and the hands. This is something I see all the time, and it can lead to severe consequences. Unfortunately, everybody knows you could lose your toes, your foot, or more. You know, this leads to a lot of problems. I'm gonna specifically focus on the feet and the ankles and how to get it better and what studies show about peripheral neuropathy. There are 600 plus papers every year about peripheral neuropathy. Basically, I like to think about it kind of like aging of the nerves. And diabetes, unfortunately, makes you age very rapidly, but there's other things. There's smoking, there's alcohol, there's thyroid diseases, there's not taking great care of yourself, there's being obese, there's beating up your body, there's being on your feet 16 hours a day, every day. All these things add up and rapidly damage your nerves, your blood vessels. So that's how you have to think about peripheral neuropathy, even though diabetes is the number one cause. There's a lot of confusion and poor consensus about peripheral neuropathy, but personally, even though it's not a guarantee it's gonna go all the way better, and look, if it's completely damaged, it might not get all the way better, but I've seen patients really turn it around, really get healthier, get stronger muscles, get better sensation, and these are the things that can help with that. So diabetes not only causes peripheral neuropathy, but damages your blood vessels, and the blood vessels now damage the nerves. Another cause is low vitamin B. That can do it. Low vitamin D as well, so B as in boy and D as in dad. There's a lot of different causes. The longer you have diabetes, the more you're going to have damage. And eventually, long-term diabetics, 60 to 70% of them are going to experience peripheral neuropathy if you don't do something to turn it around. So this is really the trick. Go see your podiatrist, get a foot exam, go see your primary care doctor. You have to get evaluated because the root cause is proper diagnosis. A lot of the times I see people watching these videos and it doesn't seem like they're talking about peripheral neuropathy at all. And we're gonna address that in this video. But the number one thing you can do is see your doctor and take care of your single biggest medical problem. So if your blood sugar is uncontrolled, get that blood sugar controlled, get yourself as healthy as possible. So number one, reduce your blood sugar, so medications. The next biggest things are weight loss and gaining muscle. I'm a huge believer in this. There's some great books, and there's one called Eat to Live. And as an example, I'm gonna link that book below. This book basically goes over studies where people who can gain muscle and lose weight rapidly, their diabetes and their blood sugar levels shrink like crazy. That's the single biggest thing you can do, is build muscle and get your body weight down. If you can do those two things, that's the trick. It's easier said than done. But if you can accomplish that, that's one of the biggest things towards your health that you can do. Stop smoking. If you're a smoker, you have to stop. There's no question about it. Nothing to even debate. Just do everything you can to stop. Otherwise, your health won't get better. If you weigh a lot, the more you can get your weight down, the key though is don't lose good weight at the same time. You have to strengthen your muscles and drop the bad weight. That's a whole different conversation, but you have to do it. Alcohol. Alcohol is a major cause too. Alcohol. If you stop drinking alcohol, that's really gonna help you. That's gonna take great care of your body. It's gonna give you a lot of energy to do all the other stuff we're talking about. Vitamins. The biggest and most proven vitamin is vitamin B as in boy. So don't go crazy and don't go buy like specific peripheral neuropathy treatments. There's not a ton of proof, even though there's new proof coming out every day, so it's possible we might be missing something. But in general, when I go to conferences, as long as you take your basic supplements, as long as you get checked out by your doctor, that's all you should do. Don't go buy the crazy $5,000 treatments that are unproven. Massaging is best performed with either a cold can or non-cold devices. Sometimes with peripheral neuropathy, cold stuff can irritate your nerves. If it's true peripheral neuropathy, the cold may be bad. But if it's musculoskeletal,
icing a bottle, and I'd be careful using a can. A plastic bottle might be better so it doesn't explode in your fridge, but just roll it for like 10 to 15 minutes on the bottom of your arch. There are some fancy ice ball devices out there. You can use them on the bottom of your foot, but the problem is they don't really stick around. So thumbs down on that one. Realistically, use a ice bottle, but if it's in your legs, in your calf muscles, that can work great. These rubber balls, they're like a dollar. They really come with other stuff. You can get these for dirt cheap prices. It doesn't have to be anything expensive. But sitting there or even standing on this thing, it can really work out your arch if it's your plantar fascia. And there's harder ones, there's softer ones. I'm using a harder one right here. That can really stretch out and get rid of a lot of that swelling right there. Once you massage, I always recommend massaging first. Look at that. It gives me much more flexibility right off the bat. I massaged my hamstrings and my calf muscles already, but then you stretch. So realistically, if you can't reach your toes, start with a towel. Just bend up that hamstring, bend up that calf muscle, get that pulled up, get it in good shape, get that foot feeling really good. And that does a great job. So you can do your right foot and then you can do your left foot, but getting that fluid out of there, getting that stiffness out of there, especially before you go to bed or when you wake up in the morning, this will really pay dividends in terms of getting that swelling and eventual nerve pain down. Home remedies that do have some evidence are taking basic daily multivitamins. So vitamin B specifically is a big one, but some studies are out there showing vitamin D as in dog as well. So B as in boy and D as in dog. Topical creams. Personally, I see a lot of success with Biofreeze. So a lot of the times, if you're having pain on the bottom of your foot, just rub it on the bottom of your foot. Biofreeze can really take the edge off. It's kind of like icing a sore muscle, but it can last a little bit longer. There's actually studies out there showing how well it works. Things that increase your blood flow, like stopping smoking, warm baths, getting your health better, getting your heart function better, that will deliver more blood flow to your nerves. So anything you can do to get healthier, that counts as a home remedy too. Exercise, cardiovascular exercise. Here's the trick. Don't do the treadmill, don't do jogging, because if your feet are numb, you could develop blisters, foot wounds. That's a big mistake I see people doing. Don't use the treadmill. Do stuff like swimming, water aerobics, especially if you're heavy. You know, start with low intensity weightlifting and muscle strengthening. If you can get your muscle strength up, that's gonna burn a lot of calories and soak up all that sugar. Essential oils can be helpful. So things like lavender oil and chamomile oil, there actually are studies that putting this on your skin can open up the blood vessels a little bit and reduce some of that pain. It's not a permanent fix, but it can help just like the Biofreeze. Another one is capsaicin. So this is cayenne pepper extract. These are sold in most pharmacies. This can really help just applying some. Check the packets at the store. Medication. This is where seeing your doctor comes in. But there's ones like gabapentin, Lyrica, the tricyclic antidepressants. There's a lot of different medication out there that can kind of cool it down. But I see a lot of patients where they're maxed out on all these medications. They're getting dry mouth. They're getting a lot of symptoms. I'm not a huge fan of going first line medications. Try this other stuff first. A lot of this stuff works for a lot of patients, but always get evaluated by your doctor and trust them if they do recommend a medication. Acupuncture. I can't really speak to this, but I have seen a lot of patients come in and have gotten acupuncture and they swear by the results. So again, I can't verify this personally, but I have seen people come in and have lots of great results. Hemp oils, so all these marijuana type products. Again, there's some evidence out there. I wouldn't call it the highest level evidence, and I have seen some patients really swear by this stuff, but when I look up some of these creams, I see it's basically stuff like Biofreeze mixed with a small amount of a little hemp extract or THC, whatever they put in there. So is that worth the extra money? I don't know. Personally, I'd try some of the other healthier, easier stuff first. But the biggest home remedy, check out a book like Eat to Live. If you can get that weight down, that's really gonna help. Massaging is huge. If you can massage and ice your feet, that can really make a big difference.
Massaging devices can work great. This foam roller is not for everybody. If you're like 60, 70, 80, you might not be able to foam roll, so wait till the end of this clip. But getting your glutes, your sciatic nerve, your hamstring, this really squeezes a lot of the inflammatory fluid out of your hamstrings, your glutes, because a lot of the nerve impingement and soreness can come from there. So simply doing this for like 30 seconds can really get that nerve swelling and tenderness down that can make your feet and your legs feel better. If you can't reach down there, get one of these sticks. It's like $7 to $10.
at some points down in the show notes, but just massaging your calf muscles. When you get up in the middle of the night and you're having a lot of pain, this mobilizes the fluid, gets rid of the inflammatory fluid. It's like a nice massage that you can do yourself at any point. I always do this before I go to sleep, especially if I've been on my feet 16 hours at the hospital. Just get your plantar fascia, your arch. If you can't reach down, just get one of these rubber balls and or a tennis ball and just roll your arch at the bottom of your foot. That gets the blood flowing and it can make your nerves feel a whole lot better potentially.
Walk it off. If you wake up in the middle of the night and you're having a lot of pain and your feet drop over the edge, that might just not be neuropathy. That might be a blood flow problem. But if you start walking, that'll get the blood flowing a little bit and that'll supply those nerves a little bit of blood flow. So a lot of times that's what makes sense with getting up and walking is if your feet are up, there's not enough blood flow getting there. But at the same time, if your feet are down, swelling can build up and that could create some back pressure against your arteries too. So in some patients, it could be a venous problem where you want to have your feet up, but in other people, it can be an arterial problem where you want your feet down. But in some people, it's both problems, which unfortunately you got to fluctuate between the two over time. Soak your feet. Warm baths can really help with the peripheral neuropathy tenderness, but we're talking lukewarm. Check with your hand or your elbow, because if your foot has poor sensation, don't burn your feet with scalding hot water. That could lead to disaster. Make sure you get enough sleep. People who don't get enough sleep, they sense pain quite a bit more. And I see this a lot after surgeries too. If people have a lot of pain, they don't sleep well the first night, they're gonna have a lot more pain over the next few days. So make sure you're getting enough sleep. Get to bed early. Don't watch TV late. Topical lidocaine. This is another medication that can work really well, but it's expensive. I wouldn't recommend it. There's better solutions. Get great home slippers. This is one of the number one improvements that I see. This is the big one. I would say this is probably number one. People with diabetes like to be barefoot because they feel unsteady when they're walking. But wearing a good slipper, and they're linked below, with an insert, that will really provide you a lot of support. Simply moving into a shoe, even though it's annoying to put on, will make a lot of difference. And why are slippers and shoes good for you? Check this out right here. When you land like this, look at how much the foot flattens out. Look at that flattening right there. That stretches all these nerves down here. So see all these nerves down here? When that foot flattens, it stretches them out. It's kind of like someone's punching your nerves every time you're walking. That's not true nerve damage. That's physical damage from walking. So watch this. With an insert, look at how stable your foot is. Nothing's stretching there, but without the insert, look at how much it collapses. So get yourself a shoe with some support. You don't have to go quite crazy with an expensive custom insert, but look at that. And if you put that in a great pair of shoes, look at this shoe. It doesn't really bend. It's got a stiff heel. You put the orthotic in there and you put the foot in there. It doesn't flatten out. That's a stable foot. It's got a lot of cushion. That nerve bruising will go right down. You're gonna start feeling a whole lot better. And you don't need an extensive custom insert. Check this out. This is under 20 bucks right here. Provides a lot of support. It's nice and soft. These work really well. Shoes are really important because check out this. This provides you no support, nothing. Your foot is gonna stretch out just like it would without the orthotic. But check out a shoe like this right here. Look it. It's got a curve along the bottom, so it curves while you move. Plus, it's got a stiff heel. Look at how much cushion is there. That's a lot of cushion. Whereas, check these out. No cushion, it's flat, it jams, and it bends. Your foot absorbs all that stress. So good orthotic, good shoe. This is most important. You're losing weight, you're gaining muscle, and what happens is people are very uneven. One hip's tighter than the other. You have back problems, you have hamstring problems, you have knee problems. That makes your one foot walk turned out. That makes the other foot flatten out. Maybe you're leaning all your body weight onto one foot or the other. That's why one hurts more than the other. Problems like these are not nerve pain. These are biomechanical problems. Stretching, exercising. This is what we're gonna talk about next.
Key is warm up when you wake up. Do some ankle circles. So move your feet, stretch out those nerves. As you stretch out those tissues, you get that fluid out of there. So when you wake up in the middle of the night, moving your feet around, walking, doing a little bit of stretching. This is my morning routine and nighttime routine that I would do if I had some neuropathy pain. Just stretch out your calves, stretch out those muscles. As you mobilize that fluid inside your muscles, it gets flowing, it circles out of those compartments, and there's less stretching. Like, for example, in your plantar fascia, as you massage it, there's less soreness, less fluid, less swelling. Massage that out when you get up. Get that fluid out of there. I love using towels because it gives you that extra stretch without leaning into your toes. It makes it a little bit softer because especially people have soreness throughout their toes. And there's nerves, just like carpal tunnel in your wrist, there's nerves that come down your ankle. This is called tarsal tunnel. What you also want to do is sciatic nerve through your hip, through your thigh, through your groin area. You want to stretch that out. Get your glutes, get your hamstrings stretched out. I love this stretch board because this is how you can make measurable progress. Start on the basic setting, which is like 15 degrees, move up to 20 degrees right there. And then after like a couple weeks, you can work your way up to now 25, 30 degrees, and then like 35 degrees right there. And then eventually it goes up to like 45 degrees right here. And work your way up, get that flexibility going. Get gradually more and more flexible, and gradually your muscles will get less sore, less achy, and you'll develop less of that soreness and swelling throughout your muscles. So there's these little half moon devices. Realistically, if you do it barefoot, you're gonna be in some pain. It's gonna make your nerve pain worse. As I mentioned, get good shoes, get good inserts that makes your foot cushion and it stretches out your hamstring, your calf muscle. When you get up in the middle of the night with nerve pain, you can stretch that out, get that blood flow mobilized. This thing's like 10 to 15 bucks. Realistically, I don't recommend it because you can do that entire big ankle slant board. That thing's a little bit better personally. So see this thing, the ankle slant board, that works pretty good right there. And then work your way up to the higher levels. It gives you an even better stretch. I do that while I brush my teeth, getting ready for bed at night. And that's it. Just get yourself a routine where you focus on getting your muscles strengthened, getting your calf muscles, your hamstrings. Using these different devices can help. Or you don't need... Thanks for watching this video on peripheral neuropathy. Click like, click subscribe. We really appreciate you, and we're going to keep bringing you great videos. Thanks for watching.